I'm Reece Stein with Marianne at your leisure on the ultimate winter escape, a cruise to the Southern Caribbean and coastal Central America. Vibrant and ever-changing, the beat of the Caribbean is an irresistible lure. Undoubtedly some of the world's best and most beautiful year-round beaches, tropical jungles full of adventure and beauty, human history back over 1,000 years, and stunning colonial architecture that has survived nature's wrath. Marianne and I picked a cruise that hit it all and much more. We stopped at the ABC Islands off the coast of Venezuela. Bonaire, the B with neighboring A, Aruba, and C, Curacao, has the oldest marine reserve in the world. Bonaire's many coral reefs are among the healthiest and most spectacular in the Caribbean, easily accessible on a day tour off the cruise ship. These shallow reefs in calm, warm water offer exceptional marine life and some of the world's best snorkeling and diving. A jaunty bus ride with enthusiastic driver Nila around surprising Aruba. This marine tropical island is the driest of the ABCs, what with brilliant sun, not much rain, and constant breezes leading to the dramatic desert landscape. But the gleaming white sand beaches and warm, clear waters draw crowds of sunseekers for swimming, diving, and snorkeling. A member of the Kingdom of the Netherlands, its capital, Oranjestad, features many lively buildings transformed into Dutch colonial landmarks, a wonderful city for a post-beach stroll and a bit of shopping. A pedestrian bridge links the two halves of Willemstad, capital of Curacao, the Sea Island. Known for its colorful Dutch colonial city center, a World Heritage Site, Willemstad is also home to the world's oldest Jewish congregation in the Americas, dating from 1651. We also visited the Hatu Caves on the north coast. These caverns of marine coral limestone are a fun addition to a visit to historic Curacao, as is the famous Senor Distillery that has produced the island's namesake liqueur for 125 years. It's made from dried orange peels. Prost! Cartagena, Colombia, on the mainland coast, is one of the world's best preserved cities from the Spanish colonial period. Its walls and fortifications are the most extensive in South America and have protected this stunning historic city since the late 16th century.
Best things about Cartagena is the streets and the people, you know. We are Caribbean right here. It's the weather, it's the people, it's the history. It's very nice, very beautiful city, Cartagena.
The formidable Castillo San Felipe de Barajas, a triangular-shaped fort, overlooks the main sea lines into Cartagena. A popular tourist draw, the fort, with its thick walls, intricate network of tunnels, is today used for social, cultural events, as well as governmental occasions. The castle, along with the city center, are protected as a World Heritage Site. The Spanish Inquisition seems an odd subject for a museum, but here it is in Cartagena, complete with the tools of torture and death. It's believed that 800 non-Catholics were killed here in the 17th century. Ironically, the museum is one of the city's best examples of colonial architecture. Near the coastal town of Santa Marta, an easy walk into the Colombian rainforest offers a stark contrast to the big city. The one-mile-long trail crisscrosses a shallow stream to a beautiful waterfall cascading off a rocky hillside, perfect for a relaxing dip and a more than ideal way to wrap up a trip to the Southern Caribbean. Reece Stein with this week's Where To adventure in Colombia, South America.